What's up, everybody? On this episode of Roscoe's Reef, it's time for an update. So let's get to the tank and see what's going on. So starting on the left-hand side of the tank is the overflow. Now, when I first chose corals to populate the overflow, I was looking for the corals that would take up the most space. Now, after having it for a while, I realized that the choice of the chalice, the Hollywood Stunner, was not really a good choice for doing this, in that what happens is it shades out anything underneath it, so the selection of corals for right by the overflow became somewhat of a problem, in that they had to be corals that could survive on a lower lighting condition. Since that time, I've been choosing more of acros. In this case, you can see the red digi, the forest fire digi next to it, which has grown a lot since I put it there, and also a frag of the green spongiotes from Fisher Hex. And also there is a frag of purple digi right above it. Now, with these growing out the way they do and branching, it will allow more light onto the sand bed and making coral selection for the sand bed a lot easier. Moving down is the purple golden green candy canes, which are really doing well and growing very nicely. They are filling out, and also being that they're right underneath the chalice, kind of lends them to fill out more, because I'm finding out that they can survive in many different lighting conditions. Finishing out the left hand side is the rainbow trachea, which has also grown some very slightly since the last update, but it's still growing just the same. The acans, the favias that are sitting in this area, the blastos, and also the fungia plate, all doing well. And I haven't shown this one in some time. This is that button coral that came in as a frag. If you look back towards the earlier update, you'll see just how small this was when I got it and just how big it's come to this date. So these corals have thrived in this area, and you could also see on the blasto how those two top polyps have now yielded to the ones that are underneath it growing out from below. Now populating the shelf is the blue and green tip torch. It really enjoys this section of the tank, and the upflow is what I feel is optimal for the torch's health. So it is really thriving in this area, and the red setosa that's in the back has really, really come a long way. As you can see right there, the amount of thickness and plating is really just coming out like a plate right now, with a few branches sticking up, has really, really made it a spectacular piece over on this side. But also, keeping it away from the tentacles of the torch are a priority, and the upflow lends itself to keeping them away from any coral that I have here, as well as this piece that I picked up from Lancaster, which is a red acro with white polyps. Again, that's also coming from Fisher Hex. Moving down into the acan garden, you can see a lot of my acans are filling out really, really well. The little pink ones right there in the middle have increased in size, as well as all the rainbows, and this green rainbow is ridiculous, as well as the orange and green Micromusa right here. The polyps have really increased in size, and the feeding regimen that I have them on with Reefroids and Mysis has done really, really well. Into the middle of the tank, you have the birthday cake coral. You can see it in recent days, since my last update, it has changed color dramatically from a light orange to different shades of orange, and also now you can see it's starting to encrust onto the rock to the right of it and starting to travel upwards. This Favia, the open brain Favia, is also doing well and encrusting down. Very slow growers, so don't expect a lot of growth out of these corals, but they will grow over time. Now, top right, you have the main colony of green spongiotes that started as a small frag. You can see just how much growth that's happened with that one. Moving up, you can see just how thick it is, and I'm really impressed about how that's filled out, especially being up closer to the light. More and more greens come out. This is a chalice that I picked up from Jason Fox, and since I put it in the tank, I picked this up at the Lancaster show, and since I put it in the tank, it has grown out somewhat, but the colors are amazing, and really the camera does not do it justice. It's showing a lot of green on the camera, but what it really is a lot of oranges and darker oranges and yellows and greens. The Sunny D's and also the Fiji Fires are doing well. Right here you have the Mushroom Rock. You can see just how many different babies there are and how many are growing on the rock. There is a bigger one behind that rock in that cave that I won't be able to pick up on camera, but I pretty much call that the parent to all these little babies. There's the Night Before Christmas Favia, and my frog spawn with the two clowns that host it, as well as right here are the rock flower anemones that are growing and just getting really bigger in size week to week. Now, pulling back out from the frog spawn, the frog spawn itself is not that full right now. It's still early in the morning. My lights have only been on for about 2 hours, and it's just the blues. So it hasn't filled out to its way it usually is. It'll grow probably twice that size at midday. But right above it are two pieces of frog spawn that I have. Both of these I'm going to be looking to remove from the tank and get them out to a home, so this way I have more area to put other corals. In the back of the tank is something that I haven't really talked about in a while, and that's the neon green candy canes. These are the last remaining heads from the colony that took the big hit, but they've been quietly growing and recouping back here, and this is where I'm going to keep them for the time being and let that grow bigger and bigger. So look out for more reports on this one as time goes by. Now, right here is the Parietes coral that I have, also known as the Christmas worm rock. As I said on my last episode, this is basically an SPS, so it does well in light. This has actually been turned around from the way it was orientated in the video. So that's why there's that larger, lighter area at the bottom that almost looks like die-off, but it's not. I'm letting it stay on this side to grow out and populate that. But since I've moved it up here, a lot more greens and a lot more reds are showing up. And also, you can see just the massive feather duster worms on it that really do well when there's flow on the piece, as you can see. To the left of that is this piece of Millie that I got from Ocean Gallery. This is the one I talked about on my Ocean Gallery visit video. And again, cameras do not do this piece justice. This is all different kinds of pinks, orange, yellows, and greens, and it's a stunning, stunning Millie, and it just caught my eye when I first saw it. As you can see, there is encrusting going on the plug. When I bought this, it had those two nubs you see at the top weren't there, and the amount of encrusting to the plug wasn't there, and that in that short time, this coral has grown to that. Growing out those little nubs and that encrusting. So I'm looking forward to that coral actually growing really, really well. Which leads me to the last part of the update. Here is the red Monty cap that I have. You can see just how big it's gotten since the last update. It's filling out that entire back right section of the tank. You can see right there, there's a peppermint shrimp actually hosting underneath it. I bought them to try and get rid of the Aptasia, and they have done nothing. So those people who are looking for peppermint shrimp to do the job, I mean, there may be success stories out there, but for me, that didn't work out. But again, this is about the coral, so you can see just how many plates have formed on the cap. Now, the last part of the update is going to be the SPS rock, starting with the Barney Coral. Increasing in size really, really dramatically. More on the back where it's facing the light, but the colors are ridiculous. There's all kinds of purples and blues and light blues. The tips are this light blue, so it looks like it's white on your screen, but it's actually a light blue. So I'm really impressed with this coral, and it's getting to the point now that I'm almost getting ready to pop some frags off. As you can see right here, the amount of and crusting that's been going on the rock from the Barney Coral is ridiculous. It's almost getting to the point that that SPS right there is going to have to be moved to keep out of its way. Right there is the Fisher Hex Millie, and I'm almost at the point now that I'm going to hopefully get those two middle ones out of there and drop that down, because I think that it's too high to light, and that's what's dulling the colors. Because now that I have that other Millie from Ocean Gallery, it's showing me exactly where they like to be in the tank. This piece of SPS from Travis over at Fisher Hex is doing really well, branching out, and it's grown to about 3 inches, even though it looks a little smaller on the video. Also, this purple and green polyped piece of SPS, the acro in the back, also doing well. So the SPS rock itself, with all the different pieces that I have on it, never lets me down, and there's always new growth to see on it. So as far as my tank itself, I know I can support SPS, and that also makes me very, very happy. So moving out to a more of a wide shot of the tank, as far as the livestock is concerned, everything's doing well. My yellow tang and powder blue tang are the largest fish in the tank. The powder blue has been a pain in the neck at times, and but he is the mascot of the channel. So for the time being, until I get to a larger tank, he's going to be basically the boss of the tank. On the right hand side, you can see the clownfish are doing well. Since I added the black and white clown that's hanging out and just going off to the right, the orange Ocellaris that was the male has turned into the female, and as you can see, is the larger of the two. So right there you can see actually the size difference. They haven't bonded as far as a mated pair yet. They are still trying to figure themselves out, and they even get into some little tiffs from time to time. But I'm hopeful that they do become a mated pair and start laying eggs in the tank. So basically that's it for this week. If you like what you see and you have a comment or a question, please leave it down in the box below. Check out the links to the people that I mentioned on the video and give them some love. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you can get reminded of new videos coming up. If you are already a subscriber, thank you again for supporting the channel. Videos will be coming a lot more regularly now, as I did take a little time off, and I appreciate you being patient with that. So that's it for now, and as always, this is Scott, and I will see you next time around the reef tank.
Thank you for watching this episode of Roscoe's Reef with Scott. As always, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe.